Hi everyone, myself Khushi Banerjee from Asansol Engineering College from the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. So in the last class, we studied about the 3x3 crossbar matrix. Today we will study about the 6x6 crossbar matrix. So from the diagram we can see that these are the inlets A, B, C, D, E, F and these are the outlets A, B, C, D, E, F. Now let us suppose these subscribers wants to communicate with these subscribers. So how will the total matrix look like? It will be like AA, AB, AC, AD, AE and AF continuing to FA, this is F, and from this side A to FB, FC, FD, FE and FL. So this will be the total matrix, that is this into this, similarly this into this. So ultimately we will get the matrix like this. Now for the first case we want to communicate the subscriber A with subscriber C. And for the second sequence, we want to see that communication of subscriber B with subscriber E. So these are the two sequences we will study today. That is, first case is subscriber A with C and the second case is subscriber B with E. So in the diagram also we can see that subscriber A is talking to subscriber C. Similarly, subscriber B is talking to subscriber E. So what will be the various steps for this communication? A to B and A to C and B to E. So what is the first step? We have already seen this in the earlier class as in 3x3 crossbar matrix. That is, for a contact point to come close to each other, the first step is first the horizontal bar needs to be energized or then the vertical bar. It can be vice versa also, that is first vertical then horizontal. So a particular sequence needs to be maintained. In this case we have taken the example that is first the horizontal bar will be energized then the vertical bar will be energized. So for the communication between A and C, first horizontal bar is energized and then the vertical bar C is energized. So a cross point, that is AC, will get dashed. That is, from this diagram also we can see first A will be energized and then C will be energized, due to which the AC will be lashed and the communication between AC will now begin. Now what is the next step? We want B to communicate with E. So what will be the first step? We need to first energize the horizontal bar B. Now AC is already being lashed. We need this B and E to get lashed. That is, this cross point BE to need lashed. So what is the first step? The horizontal bar B will be energized. Now, as we energize the bar B, the vertical bar C is already energized. So what can happen? This BC might get lashed, as it is written here. BC may get lashed. So we do not want this BC to get lashed. Now what could be done to prevent BC to get lashed? We can maintain a particular sequence. That is, first horizontal, then vertical. So in this case, what is happening? Here, first vertical is energized, that is C. And then the horizontal bar B is energized. So the sequence is not maintained in this case, due to which we can avoid the lashing of the contact point BC. That is, a particular sequence needs to be maintained, first horizontal then vertical, that is first B and then C. But for the case of BC, we can see that first the vertical bar B is energized, then the horizontal bar C is energized, then the horizontal bar B is energized. So in this case the sequence is not maintained, so BC won't get lashed. Now what is the next step? The horizontal bar B is energized. For BE to communicate, that is BE to communicate, we need to energize this vertical bar E. Now as we energize this vertical bar E, what will happen? Which are the bar energized? A is energized, B is energized, as well as E is energized. So which are the latches which may be formed? AC is lashed, as well as we can see that AE might also get lashed. But we do not want that AE should be getting lashed. We want only BE to be get lashed. So to avoid the latching of this communication point AE, what could be done? That is, first energize the horizontal bar, then vertical bar, then after the latch is being formed, like in this case, after AC is being lashed, de-energize the horizontal bar A. So as we de-energize the horizontal bar A, AE won't get lashed because A is de-energized. So the contact point which will be lashed is only BE. So what are the various steps which needs to be followed? First energize horizontal bar, then energize vertical bar, then de-energize horizontal bar. The sequence can be reversed also, that is, energize vertical bar, energize horizontal bar, then de-energize. vertical bar. So in this way, 6 by 6 cot square matrix works. Thank you.